Ukrainian Minister of Strategic Industries, Oleksandr Kamyshin, revealed during a ministry briefing that the newly deployed FrankenSAM air defense systems are actively safeguarding the front line against Russian air attacks. Kamyshin's statements were reported by the Ukrainian public broadcaster, Suspilne. He was reported as saying, by local sources, "The first solutions from the FrankenSAM project portfolio are already operating on the battlefield. In the United States, with the Minister of Defense, we saw systems developed jointly by Ukrainian and American companies. And at the same time, they're now operating on our front line. They can protect critical infrastructure and cities. These solutions allow us to have our rapid air defense." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how FrankenSAM could be very useful for Ukraine. Let's get into the details. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. To sustain a conflict like this, Ukraine needs a lot of weapons. Apart from direct transfer of platforms, Ukraine is focusing on collaborative efforts to meet its requirements. Addressing a press conference on December 27th, Kamyshin announced the creation of 5 rapid hybrid solution projects in collaboration between the U.S. and Ukraine. These initiatives aim to significantly enhance the country's air defense capabilities, as reported by Ukrainska Pravda. The minister highlighted the improvised nature of these defense systems, emphasizing their crucial role in protecting Ukraine. The minister said, "The main advantage of such solutions is speed. It takes 3 to 4 years to develop a new air defense system, and we're already receiving finished products." He elaborated on these hybrid systems. "There are various short, medium, and even long-range projects. We do not want to compete with our partners, but rather create a new market they could not enter. We get a rapid air defense upgrade, and they get the opportunity to integrate their systems into new markets. FrankenSAM is one such project." Three variants of the U.S.-implemented FrankenSAM project are U.S. Sea Sparrow missiles integrated into Soviet-era Buck launchers, the U.S. Sidewinder air-to-air missile coupled with a Soviet radar, and an additional, more potent variant whose details are not disclosed. RIM-7 Sea Sparrow is a U.S. shipborne, short-range, anti-aircraft and anti-missile weapon system. It has a range of 12 miles, or about 20 kilometers. Ground-launched Sea Sparrow is not new. Taiwan operates ground-based Sea Sparrows as part of the Skyguard Shored system. 500 missiles entered service in 1991 and are deployed on trailers with 4 box launchers. A single Sea Sparrow missile costs around $165,400. The AIM-9 Sidewinder, where AIM stands for Air Intercept Missile, is a short-range, supersonic, heat-seeking air-to-air missile. The missile's main components are an infrared homing guidance section, an active optical target detector, a high-explosive warhead, and a rocket motor. The infrared guidance head enables the missile to home in on the target aircraft engine exhaust. Through this mechanism, the missile can acquire the target after it's been launched from the aircraft. 9X is the newest variant of Sidewinder and is thought to have a range of 30 miles or 48 kilometers, though the exact specifications are classified. In an interview with Financial Times, an unnamed official noted that Kyiv is giving its U.S.-supplied AIM-9 air-to-air missiles, supposedly out of operation, a second lease on life by employing them in surface-to-air missiles. The official said, "We fixed them," to the publication. "We found a way of launching them from the ground. It's kind of self-made air defense. Each Sidewinder costs about $450,000. Ukraine has been constantly facing aerial attacks from Russian forces. According to a recent report, the Ukrainian Air Force highlighted that during the 22-month invasion, Russia launched 3,700 Shahed attack drones and approximately 7,400 missiles at various locations in Ukraine. The report indicated that Ukrainian air defenses successfully intercepted and downed 2,900 drones and 1,600 rockets. Shahed drones have been a major issue. The Shahed 136 drones that Russia has rebranded as Garand 2 are packed with explosives and are pre-programmed to loiter overhead until they nosedive into a target. Costs around $20,000 apiece. These are relatively cheap and hence are being launched by Russia in large numbers in an effort to overwhelm the Ukrainian defenses. Russia is trying to bring Ukraine to the negotiating table using this tactic. On January 3rd, the president of Ukraine, Volodymyr Zelensky, stated in a tweet, "In just a few days between December 29th and now, Russia has used about 300 missiles and over 200 Shahed drones against Ukraine. Prior to Ukraine, no country in the world had ever successfully repulsed such combined attacks with the use of drones and missiles. Only today, 10 Kinzhals were shot down. I'm grateful to every warrior in our air forces, all fighters and mobile air defense groups, every anti-aircraft gunner, and everyone throughout the world who is assisting Ukraine by providing weapons to defend our skies. Each additional air defense system and missile saves more lives. It is here in Ukraine and with our air defense that we must demonstrate that democracies are capable of protecting lives from all types of terror. Ukraine has been provided with several high-end air defense systems, like German-made IRST-T and American Patriot. But these are pretty costly to operate. The estimated cost of the PAC-3 interceptor used in Patriot is around $3 million. So these can't be used to fend off mass attacks of cheap drones due to economics. High-end air defense systems should be used to take out threats like Kinzhal, and low-cost alternatives should be put to use for cheap drones and missiles. In this condition, FrankenSAM variants could be extremely useful for Ukraine."
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.